Hello everyone and welcome back to another most important and interesting session of the defense updates provided by SSB Crack Exams. Since the last 3 days, I have already told you that we will be covering up the most important updates covering from the dates of the 14th of September 2020 all the way up towards the 12th of October 2020. The 1 month defense updates were not covered by us. So this particular session will be a very special session covering all the important updates that were not covered, and each and every particular information is considered to be very important, and this is the 1 month marathon, the special news updates provided by us. And before beginning, as I always every time introduce to you that about this is BCrack exams, that we are one stop solution for you if you're preparing for various defense examinations like NDA, CDS, AFCAT, INET, Territorial Army and Indian Air Force, Admin Group X, Group Y and Central Armed Police Forces examinations. I highly recommend you to download our Android app from Google Play Store and follow us on all sort of social media platforms. That will be very helpful to you in giving up all the important inputs and important information regarding your defense exams preparation. So in this particular defense updates, we will be covering up the headlines first, and the headlines are here for you. India's first Coast Guard Academy will be established at Mangaluru, the defense spokesperson Bengaluru has said on 12th of September 2020. Around 158 acres of Karnataka Industrial Area Development Board land has been allocated and it has been set up for the ICG Academy. DRDO has conducted a successful flight test of Abhyas, the high-speed expendable aerial target. It was conducted by DRDO from the interim test range Balasore in Odisha on 22nd of September 2020. Indian Navy undertook a passage exercise with Royal Australian Navy in the East Indian Ocean region from 23rd to 24th of September 2020. Vice Admiral A.K. Chawla, PVSM, AVSM, NM, VSM, ADC, the Flag Officer Commanding in Chief of the Southern Naval Command, on behalf of the President of India, presented gallantry and non-gallantry awards to the various important meritorial personnel, the naval personnel, at the Naval Investiture Ceremony conducted at Naval Base Kochi on 25th of September 2020. The fourth edition of India-Japan Maritime Bilateral Exercise JIMEX, which is conducted biennially between Indian Navy and Japanese Maritime Self-Defense Force, was held in North Arabian Sea from 26th to 28th of September 2020. A new defense acquisition procedure, erstwhile Defense Procurement Procedure or DPP 2020, was released by the Ministry of Defense. The DAP contains policies and procedures for procurement and acquisition from the capital budget of the Ministry of Defense in order to modernize the armed forces, including the Indian Coast Guard. The Regiment of Artillery of Indian Army on 28th of September celebrates as the Gunner's Day every year, as on this day in 1827, it was raised, and presently it forms the 57th Field Regiment. Artillery has grown in strength and capability with each passing year. BrahMos surface-to-surface supersonic cruise missile featuring indigenous booster and airframe section, along with many other made-in-India subsystems, was successfully flight-tested for designated range on September of 30, 2020 from Odisha. It is one more major step in enhancing the indigenous content for this particular feat. The indigenously developed laser-guided anti-tank guided missile was successfully test-fired on 1st of October 2020, defeating a target located at a longer range, and it was conducted from a main battle tank Arjun at KK Ranges in Ahmednagar. Lieutenant General Harinder Singh has taken over as the new commandant of the Indian Military Academy. Major General Sonali Ghosal has been appointed as the additional Director General of the Military Nursing Service. Indian Air Force celebrates its 88th Air Force Day on 8th of October 2020. A scintillating air display by various aircraft where the hallmarks of the Air Force Day Parade come investiture ceremony at Air Force Station Hindon, which is located in Ghaziabad. Exercise Bongo Sagar and Korpat, which are the bilateral exercises between Indian Navy and Bangladesh Navy, were conducted on the 3rd of October 2020. It was the first edition was held in 2019, and this is considered to be the second edition, which is to be a very important one. A memorial has been built at the unit level near the KM-120 post on the strategic road, the Darbuk Shyok Daulat Beg Oldi in Ladakh, remembering for the memorial for the gallants of the Galwan Valley massacre. India successfully test fires a new version of nuclear-capable Shaurya missile off the coast of Odisha, which can strike targets at around 800 kilometers. Lieutenant General T.S.A. Narayanan becomes the 69th Colonel Commandant of the Corps of the Electronics and Mechanical Engineers. India successfully flight tests supersonic missile assisted release of torpedo, the Smart Torpedo, on 5th of October 2020 from Wheeler Island off the coast of Odisha. 71st Raising Day of Territorial Army has been celebrated on 9th of October 2020. India successfully flight tests indigenously developed anti-radiation missile Rudram off the coast of Odisha, and this missile was launched from an Su-30 Mark 1 fighter aircraft. The successful night trial of nuclear-capable Prithvi 2 missile was conducted yesterday as a part of the user trial by Army from a test range in Odisha, as said by the defense sources. Now, let us begin with the question of the day that I have posted on the 16th of October 2020, that is yesterday, and then we will go on with all of these important headlines and important news in very, very detail. So, the question that I asked yesterday was, which corps of Indian Army is previously known as the Defence Department Constabulary Centre? I repeat the question that I asked was, which corps of Indian Army is previously known as the Defence Department Constabulary Centre? And the correct answer, as you people have given, it is the Defence Security Corps. Each and every one of you has given a perfect answer. So it is the Defence Security Corps. It was founded on 25th of February 1947 at Mathura in Uttar Pradesh. Okay. As of now, it has around 31,000 personnel. The role of DSC is to ensure the protection and security of the designated defence installations against sabotage and pilferage. I repeat all of these. The main core duty of the Defence Security Corps is to provide security and protect all the important defence installations and establishments, all the important defence related centres from against the sabotage and pilferage. This particular DSC centre, DSC Records and PAO is in the city of Kannur in Kerala on the road towards the Payyambalam beach. That is it regarding the most important update. Now we will begin with the first and foremost important defence information of this particular most important monthly affairs. So the first update is that India's first Coast Guard Academy is going to come up at Mangaluru. Mangaluru is considered to be a major port, major seaport in the Indian government purview. So ICG Academy is going to be set up at Mangaluru. Around 158 acres, which is considered to be under the KIADB, which is full formed as the Karnataka Industrial Area Development Board. These 158 acres, which were under the control of the Karnataka Industrial Area Development Board, they were taken completely by the Ministry of Defense, and this is taken up for setting up of the ICG Academy. Previously, we have to understand that all the important ICG related officers and the training equipment related, all the important things were given to the ICG personnel only at the Indian Naval Academy. Now, this particular proposal on establishing the ICG Academy is considered to be a very, very important one. Indian Coast Guard operates in complex environments at sea, in the air also. It operates various type of ships, crafts, aircrafts. It has various operational aspects. It has also the maintenance, the administrative fronts, and all of them, they will pose challenge that only be met with a professionally trained manpower. So this particular academy will be making up for the needs, catering towards the needs regarding giving up the professional manpower towards the Indian Coast Guard, and this will be a very, very important update for all the important personnel. So all the officers, the men and the stakeholders regarding this particular one are very, very happy, and historically this particular information is considered to be a very, very important one. Now let us go through with the next important update, and the next update is about the Abhyas. DRDO conducts a successful flight test of Abhyas. Remember that Abhyas is not a missile, Abhyas is a target. Remember that Abhyas is not a missile, it is a target, it is an high speed expendable aerial target. The main use of Abhyas is that this particular Abhyas target, it will be used for the missiles as a targets. Understanding, for all the missiles that are flying, they should have that some particular target. You cannot launch a missile without any particular target. So this is a target that was developed by the Aeronautical Development Agency, ADA, and also by the DRDO, the Defense Research and Development Organization. ADA and DRDO both have set together, and concomitantly they have designed and developed this particular Abhyas, which is a very, very high speed, and it is an expendable. That means it expends and it flies on some particular fuel. Going through this particular speed, it has a Mach of around 0.5. okay, so this particular one is a very very important one, and it can mimic any particular aircraft. When the word mimic, it means it can simply act as a particular aircraft, or it can act as a real time scenario. So this particular missile is considered to be a very very important one, and it offers a realistic threat scenario because it is mimicking the aircraft and also this particular target is considered to be a very very important one for the practicing of all weapon systems. And Abhyas is designed for the autonomous flying with the help of an autopilot, which is also under the development or the aeronautical development establishment. So this is considered to be a very very important one, and it is also said that during the test campaign that all the important related ones, the requirement of the 5 kilometers of the flying altitude, vehicle speed of 0.5 Mach, the endurance of 30 minutes, the 2G turn capability, each and every important one were done and everything were given and it was expected properly. So this is considered to be a very very important update. Going through with the next important update for us is about the passage exercise between the Royal Australian Navy and Indian Navy, which is conducted on 23rd to 24th of September 2020 in the East Indian Ocean region. Okay, this is considered to be a very very important international defense input. This is considered to be a very very important one, and the main details regarding this one is that the exercise involved the participation of HMAS Hobart from the Australian side, which was the passing exercise. What is a passage exercise? A passage exercise is considered to be that exercise wherein which a foreign country's navy is going from some particular place A, from point A to point B, and in between they will conduct this particular exercise. Okay, so when they are going from point A to point B, from one particular place to another place, and in between when they carry out any particular drills with a foreign nation, any exercise, when they do that particular exercise is known as the passage exercise. In short form, it is also known as a PASEX. So the Royal Australian Naval warship, which is the HMAS Hobart, it was going from as it was passing on through the side, and while it was passing on, both of these have conducted in the East Indian Ocean region, a passage exercise has been done. Now it is not considered that along with this particular Australian ship, the Indian ships that have participated from our side, which include the INS Sahyadri and INS Karmak. Okay, both INS Sahyadri and INS Karmak, along with the HMAS Hobart and various other Indian patrolling aircrafts, the helicopters from both the sides have participated in this particular passage exercise. PASEX are regularly conducted by Indian Navy with units of friendly foreign navies whilst visiting each other's posts or during their endeavors at sea. This exercise was conducted in East Indian Ocean region, which reflects the growing strength of Indo-Australian bilateral relations as comprehensive strategic partners, particularly in defense cooperation in the maritime domain. Going through with the next important update is about the Naval Investiture Ceremony 2020 of the Southern Naval Command. Actually, all the important officers of the naval officers, they have to be awarded by the President of India the meritorious medals, the gallantry and the non-gallantry medals. But due to the COVID-19 pandemic, they were not allowed to visit the Rashtrapati Bhavan, and various other contingencies were also being into consideration. So it was taking into these situations in preview that all the important gallantry and non-gallantry medals were awarded at the Southern Naval Command at Kochi itself. Okay, so who awarded all of these medals? On behalf of the President of India, the Flag Officer Commanding in Chief of the Southern Naval Command, he has taken over. He awarded all the other meritorious naval personnel. Okay, who is the Flag Officer Commanding in Chief of Southern Naval Command? He is the Vice Admiral A.K. Chawla, who carries his distinctions, his medals as the Param Vishishta Seva Medal, Ati Vishishta Seva Medal, Nau Sena Medal, Vishishta Seva Medal, ID Cap. Okay, so he is the Flag Officer Commanding in Chief of the Southern Naval Command. So he presented the gallantry and non-gallantry awards to the meritorious naval personnel at the Naval Investiture Ceremony, which was conducted at INS Kochi. And when did this particular ceremony happen? It happened on the 25th of September 2020. Okay, going through with the next important update in detail regarding this particular one is that the number of medals, there were around a total of 10 medals, which included 4 Nau Sena Medal Gallantry, 2 Nau Sena Medal Devotion to Duty, 4 Vishishta Seva Medal for their long meritorious services were awarded regarding this particular one. They also awarded 1 Jeevan Raksha Padak to an important Indian naval person, and as well as unit citations were given. The Assure Unit Establishment for the year 2021 was awarded to INS Chilka, and Afloat Unit, a ship, it was awarded to INS Sujata under the Southern Naval Command for delivering their exceptional performance over the past 1 year in exact words that is mentioned here. Okay. Now, that is it regarding this particular important update. Going through with the next important information is about the JIMEX 2020, which is the bilateral maritime naval exercise between Japan and India. This is considered again a very important international naval defense input. This was conducted in the North Arabian Sea. Remember, it is conducted in the North Arabian Sea. So this is considered to be a very, very strategic location. Japan has no relation with the North Arabian Sea, but India has invited Japan for these important drills, for this JIMEX 2020. So this is considered to be the fourth edition of this particular exercise. This was first conducted long back. Okay, so it is conducted biennially. That means biennially between both Indian Navy and Japanese Maritime Self-Defense Force. And when was it conducted recently? It was conducted from 26th September to 28th of September 2020. That means it is a 3-day event. Okay, so 26th September, 27th September and 28th September, 3 days. Both Indian Navy and Japanese Navy have conducted this particular operation, and this is very, very important. It is a non-contact at sea only format, COVID-19 restricted exercise. Okay, because of the COVID-19 restrictions and all were posed, this is considered to be a very, very important one. JIMEX series of exercise actually commenced long back in January of 2012 with special focus on maritime security cooperation. The last edition of JIMEX was conducted in October of 2018 off in the Visakhapatnam in India. To get in detail regarding the Indian ships that have participated in the JIMEX 2020 exercise, which include the indigenously built stealth destroyer INS Chennai, then comes INS Tarkash, which is Take class stealth frigate, and then comes the INS Deepak, which is a fleet tanker. What are all those three important warships? They include INS Chennai, INS Tarkash and INS Deepak. These three have participated in the JIMEX along with these three various other Indian patrolling aircraft. The Boeing P-8I Poseidon aircraft also participated. From the Indian side, Rear Admiral Krishna Swaminathan, the flag officer commanding of the Western Fleet, also commanded the Indian side. Okay. Also, to get in detail regarding the Japanese ships, the Japanese Maritime Self-Defense Force ships, they were GM-SDF Kaga and GM-SDF Ikazushi. GM-SDF Kaga is the Izumo class helicopter destroyer of Japanese Navy, and GM-SDF Ikazushi is the guided missile destroyer of the Japanese Navy. On the Japanese side, Rear Admiral Konno Yasushige has commanded the Japanese side. And in addition, as I already mentioned, that Boeing P-8I long range maritime patrol aircraft, various other helicopters, fighter aircrafts have also participated in this JIMEX bilateral naval exercise. Going through with the next important update is about the Defense Acquisition Procedure 2020. Listen to each and every important word that I am talking here, because Defense Acquisition Procedure 2020 is a sure shot question that will be coming up for the coming up the CDS examination. For all those who are preparing for the CDS examination and the coming up the Central Armed Police Forces examination, one question is compulsory that we can expect from the DAP 2020, because this is considered to be a very important major update, a groundbreaking report that is provided by the Ministry of Defense towards our particular country. This is considered to be the changing factor from this particular procedure, from this particular report. All the important ways and means of procuring the military procurements from the foreign countries will now get changed, because from this particular procedure, the Indian side is focusing on indigenization. Okay, so when I'm talking about indigenization, that means all the important products that have to be manufactured, that have to be designed and developed in India. So we are focusing on Make in India, the Atmanirbhar Bharat here. So this is considered to be a very, very important. Going through the background of the DAP 2020, actually the first time it was in the year of 2002 that the defense procurement procedure was promulgated. Okay, so long back, the procedure for procuring the defense items and all, it was started, and a report for that was proposed in the year of 2002. Later, what happened in the year of 2016, a special committee was set up, and under the chairmanship of Mr. Dhirendra Singh, and that particular committee is known as the Dhirendra Singh Committee. Okay. So this particular committee, under the chairmanship of Director General Acquisition, it was constituted to review the defense procurement procedure. And then it focused on indigenously designed, developed and manufactured weapon system. Okay, why we are focusing on the indigenously designed, developed and manufactured weapon systems? Because recently we are also seeing the important news and updates regarding the Atmanirbhar Bharat Abhiyan and how Modi is trying to propose about the Make in India campaign. Because India is not a country which is now still reliant on the foreign nations, because India now has its own sort of special important economics, and India now has a very special place in the defense procedures in the world. So it is very important for us to have a capability of producing our own weapon systems. We should have also the capability of making our own manufacturing systems. Just like how China is developing its own aircraft and all, India should also reach to that particular level, because it is very important from our side in the point of the security and the safety of our nation. So what happened, because from the 2016 report that is provided by the Dhirendra Singh committee, at that it lacked a lot of issues and it lacked the vote of the transparency. That is the reason why at those times we also saw the Rafael scam and all, and it was inconvenient, proposed inconvenient offset regulations and all. So that is the reason why a special committee again was set up, and now a special defense procurement procedure, and it is now named as a defense acquisition procedure. It is laid down on 2020, this particular year, and it was proposed in October. So considering this particular one, the main objective of the DAP 2020 is turning India into a global manufacturing hub. This clearly indicates how is the Ministry of Defense looking upon to increase the viabilities and increase the safety, security and the important money lending of this particular important procedures. And going through in words that align with the vision of government of Atmanirbhar Bharat and empowering Indian domestic industry to Make in India initiative and all, we are considering all of these important inputs. Now, considering the special objectives here, this particular procedure has cut down permissible time frames for various activities. This is for the first time that a report has given proper timelines. It has given proper time frames. I will give you in a very, very detail about institutionalizing robust mechanisms to monitor for probity at various stages of acquisition process are the attributes of this DAP. Now, what are the important timelines and how this particular DAP 2020 is considered to be a very, very important one? Now, keep a very, very important concentration. Now, concentrate on this particular tabula form, which I am going to explain to you in a very detail in the next few minutes, because this is considered to be the core and the complete information regarding the defense acquisition procedure 2020. Regarding the DAP 2020, it has divided the Indian procedures, Indian buyers and the foreign buyers and the procurement of the deals in five important domains. These are the five most important domains. It has divided the buyers and the sellers into five domains. Now, the first domain is Buy Indian IDDM. IDDM means, which is Indian Designed, Developed and Manufactured. I repeat, it is Indian Designed, Developed and Manufactured. That means it is the type of vendor is Indian. If you are trying to procure any particular defense deal from an Indian vendor, from an Indian manufacturer. For example, I am some XYZ person and I have made some particular drone, for example. Okay, so I have designed, developed and have manufactured my drones in my own system itself. I have been, all of these companies that are involved in my success are all the Indian companies. Now, this is going to be coming under the first important category. Okay, so this is considered to be an Indian vendor, which is the Buy Indian, Indian Design, Develop and Manufacture, IDDM category. Okay, so all of these are developed indigenously, and for these the percentage of indigenous content on cost basis of the base contract value. Now, what is the base contract value? The base contract value is the complete deals value minus the taxes that are taken into consideration. If you're taking the base value without the taxes, now that particular, from the base contract value, the complete deal, from that whole particular indigenous content, the percentage of the indigenous content should be more than or equal to 50%. Okay, now for example, I have designed and developed a drone by myself, but I will be considering the important equations and the scientific development from some particular United States Academy's paper, for example, from the USA's paper. But still, my drone has a lot of important indigenous concepts and ideas, and if I consider the whole process, the complete cost value from all of that, more than 50% of it, if it is coming under the indigenous content, then I am applicable for this particular one. Okay, so here for all of these, it has divided one particular one. The second type of procurement, which is under the Buy Indian. Now here it is like I have designed, developed, but it is may not have been designed, developed indigenously. That means I am an Indian vendor, but I did not design or develop here in India. These all of these were done by me in some other particular country. Then this will be coming here. I need to make sure that my indigenous content should be more than or equal to 60% of the cost basis of the base contract value. Going through the next important type of procedure, procurement deal is about the Buy and Make Indian. Okay, here what does it mean? Here I am an Indian, I am tying up with a foreign original equipment manufacturer. OEM means what? It is the original equipment manufacturer. For example, I am some particular Indian company. For example, I am the Tata Advanced Systems. For example, now Tata Advanced System has tied up with some particular foreign company, for example Lockheed Martin. Now Lockheed Martin is an original equipment manufacturer. It has made some important aircraft. Now I am developing the Lockheed Martin's aircraft in India, Indian country, and I'm giving the jobs for the Indian people. Then this will be coming under the third category. Here I'm an Indian buyer, I'm an Indian vendor, which I've tied up with the foreign one. Now what happens here, it is that the initial acquisition of equipment in fully formed state in quantities. What happens is, I will first take all the important aircrafts from the Lockheed Martin company. Because I am from Tata, what Tata will do, it will take some important number of aircrafts. For example, one or two aircrafts from the Lockheed Martin. And once they have come in the fully formed state, then I will have a complete detailed procedure and analysis of that particular aircraft. And then from the procedures that are given by the Lockheed Martin, I will start producing the aircraft in my country indigenously. Okay, now the production is considered to be indigenous, but the idea and the scientific development, the knowledge behind all of it is considered to be the foreign one. Okay, so regarding all of these, here what all things have happened, it is also involves the transfer of technology also. That means all the important, the knowledge based things and all the critical technologies are all also transferred to our country. The technological transfer will also take place in this particular one. And here the indigenous content should be greater than or equal to 50% on the make portion. Why did they say it is make portion? Because here it is not designed and developed here in India. It was designed and developed in some other foreign country. The only the making and the manufacturing part is going to be considered in our country. If you're doing it in our country and in the making portion itself, while developing itself, in that, if you have greater than or equal to 50% as an indigenous content of the base contract value, then you will be coming under the third kind of vendor. Coming towards the fourth kind of vendor is about the Buy Global Manufacturer in India. Here it comes completely a foreign buyer, followed by a manufacturer in India. Here the buyer is Indian, because even though the Tata Advanced System is tied up with the Lockheed Martin, whenever Indian government has to acquire a Lockheed Martin aircraft, it will tie up with the Tata Advanced Systems only. It is not necessary for it to again tie up with the Lockheed Martin itself. Here then it is coming under the third type. But if in case the government wants to tie up with the Lockheed Martin itself, then it is going to be a foreign buyer. When it is considered to be a foreign buyer, here we have to take into consideration the manufacturing in India. Here what happens is, the transfer of technology will not take place. Okay, so from the fourth point, there will not be any kind of transfer of technology. Only manufacturing will be done in our country, that too fully or partially. Okay, for example, all the radars and all of them will be coming from the foreign country, but all the structural outfit and all will be made in India. So the design will be made in foreign, and all the important procedures, the transfer of technology will remain with the foreign partner, but only fully or manufacturally, the manufacturing will be done in our country, which are set up by the intergovernmental agreements between our government and the foreign government. There, the percentage of indigenous content on cost basis of base contract value should be greater than or equal to the 50%. The fifth kind of vendor would be a Buy Global vendor. Now, who is a Buy Global vendor? That particular vendor can be either Indian or foreign. The first three were Indians only. The fourth one was purely a foreign buyer. But the fifth one can be an Indian buyer or a foreign buyer. Here what happens, it is completely dependent upon the intergovernmental agreement. If any particular norm is not coming into consideration, which if any particular agreement, if any particular defense procurement, it is not coming under the above 4 points, then it will be coming under the fifth point, which is known as the Buy Global. Okay, and here if you are a vendor, then the government deals will happen. And for the Indian vendor, the percentage of ICE on cost basis of base contract value should be greater than or equal to 30% only, and it is absolutely nil for the foreign vendor. I hope that this particular one was very, very helpful for you. I would like to reiterate some things. Remember that there are 5 types of vendors that are produced and 5 types of acquisition that were mentioned in the defense acquisition procedure. First one was by Indian IDDM. IDDM means Indian designed and developed and manufactured. Okay. So it is all done in India. I am an Indian manufacturer, Indian designer, Indian developer, and my product has been designed and it was developed, manufactured in our country indigenously. In that case, and if among all of that, the indigenous content that I have should be more than or equal to 50%. This is considered to be the first type of contract. And the second type is about the buy Indian one. Here, I may not have designed and developed indigenously, but I am an Indian vendor. But my design and development manufacturer is not in our country, it is in some other country. In that case, the percentage of indigenous content should be greater than or equal to 60%. Coming up towards the buy and make, the Indian one, the third kind of procurement, third type of vendor would be an Indian vendor which is tied up with a foreign original equipment manufacturer. That means an Indian company tied up with a foreign company. Wherein which what happens is, first in case we will acquire the fully formed FF state products from the foreign company, then we will go through it, then we will have a proper plans and that are made, which are produced by the foreign company, and the Indian company will follow the norms that are placed by the foreign company. And Indian company will indigenously produce all the important aspects of this particular material in a phased manner involving the transfer of technology. Here the transfer of technology will happen. Okay. Now in this particular third type will be the percentage of IC will be greater than or equal to 50% of the base contract value, and this will be only for the make portion. Going through the fourth type of vendor will be a completely foreign vendor. What does a foreign vendor do? He is a foreign vendor and he wants to manufacture in India, but he does not want to have any kind of transfer of technology, and all of these will be coming up under the intergovernmental agreements, wherein which the product will be fully or partially only manufactured in India, but the design and the development will be done in the foreign country and the technological details will be kept towards that country itself. In that case, the indigenous content percentage should be greater than or equal to 50%. And the fifth point is about the buy global one. Here the vendor can be either Indian or foreign, and it completely depends on the intergovernmental agreement. There it is greater than or equal to 30% of the indigenous content on the cost basis of base contract value for Indian vendor, and it will be completely zero in the case of the foreign vendor. Now let us go through in very, very detail regarding various other important ones about what does the Defense Acquisition Procedure 2020 says. It also promotes the Make in India and Atmanirbhar Bharat initiatives, as I'm telling you since the point one itself. What happened is, here in the special points regarding this particular acquisition procedure is that it has the special reservation in categories for the Indian vendors, because Indian vendors are provided special reservation for the various categories. There is also a proposal of banning the import of certain items, and there is also a proposal of indigenization of imported spares. There are various kind of spare parts which can be manufactured in our country. It is not necessary for us to again import them from some other country, because that will be a cost wastage for us. So various load of imported spares that are important for the defense companies, and also the import of the certain items were also there, and there is a ban on the import of certain items, so that all of those items will be manufactured and indigenously made in our country itself. Previously the leasing was never kept under a particular purview, but for the first time the point of leasing was kept in a separate chapter, and it has been introduced as a new category for the acquisition in addition to the existing buy and make categories. So for this particular time, for the first time, the rents are to be paid periodically, understanding, instead of a huge capital investment. Previously the whole particular lease has to be paid once at a time, but through this particular acquisition procedure it has been reduced towards the rental payments. That means the same payment has to be made towards the lease will be paid periodically. Now doing through with this particular one, the burden for various other important Indian companies has been reduced. Okay, so in this particular way we can directly see how the defense ministry has taken into consideration of each and every aspect in a very detailed one. Also, we have to understand and go through in detail regarding the IDEX innovations for defense excellence, and we will also have to speak about the mission Gyan Shakti also. So considering about the IDEX, the innovations for defense excellence, this was previously, it was already there, so it has been operationalized to provide necessary incubation and infrastructure support to the startups in the defense area. So there are a lot of important defense startups in our country that will be helpful, because there are various other startups also which might not be knowing that they will be very, very helpful in the area of defense. So even those startups will be taken into consideration. Each and every startup of our country will be watched out, and if there is any particular startup wherein which it can provide towards the defense and the security of our country, it will be given the incubation period, it will be given the infrastructure support, will also be done through this IDEX platform. Okay, so IDEX would be further scaled up to engage with 300 more startups to develop 16 new technologies or products during the next 5 years as proposed by the DAP 2020. Also, to get in detail about the mission Raksha Gyan Shakti, this was launched way long back in the year of 2018 by the then defense minister, she is now the finance minister, the then defense minister, Mrs. Nirmala Sitharaman. So she launched mission Raksha Gyan Shakti. This is about the innovation and technology. This is about to provide and this is a mission to nurture and encourage the intellectual property rights. That means all the important defense procedures that were made in India, the startups, the ideas that are brought up by the Indian companies, they have to be kept towards the Indians itself. That means all of these ideas that are being brought up by the Indian and entrepreneurs and the Indian startup people, they have to be given their rights and they have to be given their intellectual property rights. And regarding that, this particular mission has been launched. So this is to promote greater culture of innovation and technology development and file a higher number of patents in defense public sector undertakings and also the Ordnance Factory Board too. Regarding the mission Raksha Gyan Shakti, it will be scaled up for promoting the creation of intellectual property in the sector and its commercial utilization. It is to provide a lot of awareness and training. It is to provide the consulting and advisory for identification, registration, protection of the knowledge base that are being given from the various DPSUs, from the people, from the intelligent people who are working in our country. This is also to create a platform for all those people to create a trust to all those that their ideas will not go in vain. That is it regarding the defense acquisition procedure. Now we will go through with the next important defense update, and that is about the 28th September, the Gunners Day. This is about the raising day of the Regiment of Artillery of the Indian Army. It celebrates on 28th of September every year. It's raising day, and that raising day is known as the Gunners Day, as they call. And it was on this day in the year of 1827. The 5 Bombay Mountain Battery was equipped with the guns, and that is the reason why this is considered to be a historical moment. And from that day, the 28th September is considered to be celebrated as the Gunners Day. The motto of this particular regiment is Sarvatra Izzat O Iqbal, which can be translated to English as everywhere with honor and glory. And the war cry of the Regiment of Artillery is Bharat Mata Ki Jai. And the regimental center of the Regiment of Artillery is located at Nashik in Maharashtra. Artillery now boasts of a dynamic inventory which ranges from ballistic missile, multi-barrel rocket launchers, high mobility guns, mortar precision guided munitions for destruction of enemy targets to radars, unmanned aerial vehicles and electro-optic devices for locating and carry out post-strike damage assessment. Artillery has always been a battle winning factor, and as per the new generation of warfare, its role and significance is bound to increase manifold in future. So SSB Crack Exams has already wished long back a very happy Gunners Day, and even now we wish each and every personnel of the Regiment of Artillery of Indian Army a belated happy Gunners Day. Now going through with the next important update is about the BrahMos missile featuring indigenous booster has been successfully flight tested. Now what is this BrahMos and why is this coming into news? Why is it news? It is, the main reason is because it is for the first time that the equipment in BrahMos is made indigenously. Okay, which means what? It is completely made in our country in India. So this BrahMos, which is a surface-to-surface supersonic cruise missile, it features indigenous booster and airframe section along with many other made in India subsystems. So all of these various other subsystems which are made in our country, the airframe section, the booster section, all of these are made in India, and it was tested for the first time on when it is listed on the September of 30, 2020 in early morning hours of the 10:30. Okay, so at that time it was tested and it was extremely successful. It was tested at Balasore in Odisha. That means it is tested at the interim test range ITR in Odisha. And at that time, they have observed that the speed that it reached was 2.8 Mach, which is a very, very appreciable one. Dr. G. Satish Reddy, who is the chairman of the Defence Research and Development Organisation, is also the secretary of the Directorate of Defence Research and Development. He also congratulated all the scientific community, the officials of the DRDO and various other important scientists who are involved directly and indirectly for and the industry for this particular feat that they have achieved. So this is a very important update for us to understand and remember. Going through with the next update is about the DRDO laser guided ATGM successfully flight tested. ATGM means anti-tank guided missile. Okay, so this is fired from an MBT Arjun tank. So if you want to fire a tank, then you can fire it from another tank. So it was fired from MBT Arjun. This was done at Ahmednagar from the KK ranges. Okay, so this particular launch date, this particular test fire was done on 1st of October 2020. That means the first of this month. The trials for this were started on 22nd of September, but the actual launch was done on 1st of October 2020. Now, the specialties regarding the ATGM, it is developed by the Armament Research and Development Establishment, ARD, which is in Pune. It is in also in association with the High Energy Materials Research Laboratory, HEMRL, Pune, and Instruments Research and Development Establishment, IRD, which is in Dehradun. These three are very, very important in the coming up examination. They will ask you, they will give you the names of these establishments and they might ask you where are these located. So remember the names and their places. ARD means Armament Research and Development Establishment, which is located in Pune. In the same place, High Energy Materials Research Laboratory, HEMRL, is also present. And at Dehradun, we have the Instruments Research Development Establishment, IRD. Regarding in detail, regarding the ATGM, if you have to consider, ATGM employs a tandem highly agile and extended warhead. It is a target warhead to defeat explosive reactive armor protected armored vehicles in ranges from 1.5 to 5 kilometers. Now, ATGM has been developed with multiple platform launch capability and it is currently undergoing a technical evaluation trials from 150mm rifled gun of the main battle tank Arjun. This has been done in a very successful way and Raksha Mantri Shri Rajnath Singh has congratulated DRDO for its successful feat. Secretary DD and RD and Chairman of the DRDO has congratulated DRDO personnel for this achievement. Similarly, and another one, the Samho anti-tank guided missile was also being developed and the cannon launched missile development program, which is also designed to be launched from the MBT Arjun tank gun in a very coming up day. So update regarding that will also be provided in the coming up day soon by us by SSB Crack exams. Going through the next important update is about that the Lieutenant General Harinder Singh, he has taken up as a new commandant of the Indian Military Academy. If you can remember, he was the person who was mainly involved in the talks with the China at the Ladakh side. He was the former commander of the 14th Corps. He was a 14th Corps commander long back. Now he has been transferred. He has been made as the commandant of the Indian Military Academy and is now the new commandant. He took charge in the first week of October as said from the Indian Army sources. Meanwhile, the existing commandant of the IMA, he was Lieutenant General Jaiveer Singh Negi. He was there, the incumbent commandant. He retired because of his superannuation after his 40 years of long service, exhausting and extraordinary service by him. He retired and after him, Lieutenant General Harinder Singh has taken over as a new commandant. Going through with the next important appointment is regarding the Additional Director General Military Nursing Service. She has been appointed as Major General Sunari Ghosal. She has been appointed as ADG of MNS. She took over the reins on the 1st of October 2020 after Major General Joyce Gladys Roach. She relinquished the post on a superannuation on 30th of September 2020. So on 30th of September 2020, the existing ADG of Military Nursing Service, she is Major General Joyce Gladys Roach. She has been under superannuation and she has her service was completed and in her place, Major General Sunali Ghosal has been taken over as the new ADG and she has already commissioned into the Indian Military Service in the year of 1981 and she's an alumnus of the Indian School of Nursing of the Indian Naval Hospital INS Ashwini in Mumbai. She also served as the principal matron of Army Hospital Research and Referral Delhi Khan before and after that she's been appointed here as the Additional Director General of the Military Nursing Service. Going through with the next important update is regarding the Air Force Day celebrations, the 88th Indian Air Force Day celebrations, which were conducted on 8th of October 2020, which included scintillating air display by various aircrafts with the hallmarks of the Air Force Day parade cum investiture ceremony, which was conducted at Air Force Station Hindon. Rehearsals for all of these air displays were actually started from 1st of October 2020 and they were all fruitful on 8th of October 2020 on the original occasion. Gallantry medals were also awarded to the Indian Air Force 3 air warriors who participated in the Balakot operation this particular year. If we go through in detail regarding those ones, they include the officers who received the Youth Seva Medal are Squadron Leader Minty Agarwal, Group Captain Hansel Sekera and Group Captain Hemant Kumar Vatsra. Youth Seva Medal recognizes distinguished service of a high order during war, conflict or hostilities. These medals were awarded to the Balakot operation heroes this Air Force Day, and a lot of important operations, the Tejas, were also mentioned in this particular Air Force Day parade. Going through with the next important update is about Excise Bongo Sagar and the CORPAC. CORPAC meaning the Coordinated Patrol Excise. Both of these were conducted between the Indian Navy and the Bangladeshi Navy. And this particular exercise known as the Bongo Sagar, it commenced in Northern Bay of Bengal on 3rd of October 2020. Okay, so this is for the first time. It was held in the year of 2019, long back. So it is the second time this exercise is being conducted. The main aim of this particular exercise is to develop interoperability, joint operational skills through conduct of wide spectrum of maritime exercises and operations. That means it will conduct the interoperability. That means the operations between both the navies, the joint operational skills will be tested, and they will also go through a conducting of wide spectrum. That means a lot of maritime exercises and operations will be done here. And after this particular exercise on 4th and 5th of October, a coordinated patrol was conducted. If you go through the ships that have participated from the Indian side, the Indian indigenously built anti-submarine warfare corvette INS Kilton and Indian indigenously built guided missile corvette INS Kukri have participated in this Bongo Sagar exercise and also in the coordinated patrol exercise on 3rd, 4th and 5th of October 2020. If you go through the Bangladeshi ships, they included the Bangladeshi's BNS Abu Bakr, which is a missile guided missile frigate, and BNS Protoy, which is a guided missile corvette. Both of these have participated. So from the Indian side, the INS Kilton, INS Kukri, then from the Bangladeshi side, BNS Abu Bakr and BNS Protoy, and along with these four ships from India and Bangladesh, the maritime patrol aircrafts from both the navies and integral helicopters, and all of them have participated in these exercises, in this patrol exercise. So this is considered to be a very, very important one. Going through with the next important update is about the memorial that is built for the Galwan Valley heroes, all the heroes who were there in the Operation Snow Leopard. Now if you go through the long back, on June 15th, Colonel B. Santosh Babu, he has led from the front and his troops, they have fought gallantly hand to hand in combat with the People's Liberation Army of China in the long areas of the Galwan Valley in the Ladakh areas. And 15 of them have achieved martyrdom, including Colonel B. Santosh Babu. So they were considered to be heroes of our country and they laid down their lives in the name of our country. So remembering their efforts and remembering their sacrifice towards our country, a special memorial has been built for these important gallant heroes. This has been built at the KM-120 post on the strategic road of the Dabuk Shok Daulat Beg Oldi in Ladakh. Going through with the next important update is about that India has successfully test fired the new version of nuclear capable Shaurya missile. We already had a Shaurya missile, but this is for the first time. The speciality of this particular missile is that it is a nuclear capable one, and this particular missile can strike the targets which are located at around 800 kilometers. This was launched on 3rd of October 2020 again at Balasore in Odisha. If you can see, from the same interim test range in Balasore in Odisha, a lot of missiles were conducted. In this 1 month, around 6 important missiles were carried out. The missile tests were carried out. So this is considered to be a very, very important and extraordinary feat that has been done by DRDO. Which the way they are working, this clearly indicates how much they are working for our country. So we have to be very, very careful and aware of them. If in case you are studying and if in case you are an engineer and all of those people are working for our country, want to become a part of the Indian Armed Forces, courses. I request each and every one of you all the best so that you can produce all of these important highlights for this particular country and lay down your life for this country. So this missile is a very, very important one. This Shaurya missile is a lighter one and it is an easier one when compared to the existing one. Okay, so already we had a Shaurya missile, but this nuclear capable one is lighter and more easier than the existing one. And if you go through the details regarding the news sources, they also mentioned that in the last phase of this missile, this can reach hypersonic speeds. So this is a very important update that we can understand. If we go through in detail regarding the nuclear capable Shaurya missile, then I would like to mention in detail regarding this particular one. The Defense Research and Development Organization has been working towards completing total self-reliance in the field of strategic missiles and has enhanced its efforts further after the call of Atmanirbhar Bharat by Prime Minister Narendra Modi in the defense sector earlier this year, as said by the sources. That is it regarding this particular most important update. Going through with the next important information is about that the Lieutenant General T.S.A. Narayanan, he becomes the 69th Colonel Commandant of the Corps of Electronics and Mechanical Engineers. He was also the commandant of the Military College of Electronics and Mechanical Engineers, MCME, which is located in Secunderabad. He was the commandant there and he was elected recently as also the commandant of the core of the EME. MCME is an establishment under EME, but the complete core was headed by another military official. But as of now, the recent inputs per se that he was elected for the first time, that he was also elected for the core commandant, the colonel commandant of the core of EME. Going through his service details, he was actually commissioned into the Corps of EME on December of 24, 1982, long back from IMA Dehradun. Then he also has an illustrious career which is spanning over 37 years, in which he had held various command, instructional, also coming under the staff appointments. He has also held the various regimental appointments also. So this year has been a landmark achievement for the MCEME. What did MCEME do? It also got recently the prestigious national awards were awarded towards the MCEME. The Golden Peacock National Award was given to MCEME. The AICT Utkrisht Sansthan Vishwakarma Award was also given to MCEME. Considering all of these efforts that were made by the MCEME and the efforts that were taken up by the Lieutenant General T.S.A. Narayanan, and all of these were taken into consideration for him being selected and elected as the Colonel Commandant of the Corps of EME. Going through with the next important update is about that the India successfully flight tested another important missile, and that is about the SMART-1. The SMART carries its abbreviation full form as the Supersonic Missile Assisted Release of Torpedo. That means what? This is a very, very important one. It is a torpedo. Point number one, it is a torpedo. Now, what kind of torpedo it is? It is released, it is assisted release torpedo. It is assisted by what? It is a supersonic missile assisted. That means this torpedo is assisted by a supersonic missile. So for the first time, a supersonic assisted torpedo is there, a missile assisted torpedo. So this is considered to be very, very important one. So where did this happen? It was flew off from Wheeler Island off the coast of Odisha on morning of 11:45 hours on 5th of October 2020. Okay. Now, if we go through in detail, all mission objectives, including missile flight up to the range, altitude, separation of nose cone, release of torpedo, deployment of velocity reduction mechanism, VRM, all have been met perfectly as said and mentioned here in front of your eyes. Those important establishments that have worked towards this particular smart torpedo, they include the DRDL, the RCI, which is the Research Center Imarat of Hyderabad, the ADRDE of Agra, the NSTL of Vishakhapatnam. All of these have helped and developed the technologies that are required for the SMART missile. SMART is a missile assisted release of lightweight anti-submarine torpedo system for anti-submarine warfare operations far beyond torpedo range. This launch and demonstration is significant in establishing anti-submarine warfare capabilities. Secretary Defense Development and Research and Development, the chairman of the DRDO, Dr. G. Satish Reddy, has also said that SMART is a game-changer technology demonstration in the anti-submarine warfare. Going through with the next important update is regarding the 71st Raising Day of the Territorial Army. If you go through this, it was for the first time on 9th of October 1949, the modern Territorial Army was raised by the then first Indian Governor General Chakravarti Rajagopalachari ji, and an act was passed in 1948. Annual Prime Minister Territorial Army Day Parade, it takes place every year in 9th of October. So regarding that, it has been done. If we go through in detail, the origin of Territorial Army can be traced back to 1857. It was raised as volunteers and were recruited only from the Europeans and Anglo-Indians. On 1st of October 1920, Indian Territorial Force Bill was passed, resulting in the reorganization of Territorial Army into two separate wings, namely the Auxiliary Force and Indian Territorial Force. Where the former was meant only for the European and Anglo-Indians, the latter was only purely for the Indians. Later, after independence in 1947, Territorial Army Act was enacted on 18th of August 1948 by Constituent Assembly, resulting in the constitution of the present Territorial Army. Going through in detail regarding the next important defense update is about that the India has successfully flight tested indigenously developed anti-radiation missile known as Rudram. Rudram is the anti-radiation missile. This is for the first time that DRDO has developed an anti-radiation missile, and this is for the Indian Air Force. So it was flight tested on 9th of October 2020. And it was there logged onto a radiation target located on Wheeler Island off the coast of Odisha. This particular missile, anti-radiation missile Rudram, it was launched from an Su-30 Mark 1 fighter aircraft, as mentioned here in the pictures for you. So it has INS inertial navigation system, the geographical positioning system navigation with passive homing head for the final attack, which can also detect, classify, engage targets over a wide band of frequencies as programmed by the DRDO officials. If you go through the Rudram missile, I would also mention to you towards that this particular passive homing head, as told, it can detect, classify and engage targets over a wide band of frequencies as programmed, and this missile is a potent weapon for Indian Air Force for suppression of enemy air defense effectively from large standoff ranges. With this, the country has established indigenous capability to develop long-range air-launched anti-radiation missiles for neutralizing enemy radars, communication sites, and another radio frequency emitting targets. Going through with a final update regarding this monthly marathon is about the latest additional update. Until now, we were discussing all the important updates for the 1 month, that is from the 14th of September 2020 all the way up towards the 12th of October. Because today we have not provided the defense updates of the particular day of today itself. So I'm providing this important update to you. This is the pure update for today itself. Okay, so this is a news that was conducted yesterday. So the successful night trial of nuclear capable Prithvi 2 missile was done yesterday itself. So it was yesterday night at 7:30 p.m. from Launch Complex 3 of Interim Test Range at Chandipur near Balasor, Odisha. This particular missile, the state-of-the-art indigenously developed Prithvi 2 missile, it blasted off. Okay, so it had a strike range of 350 kilometers and this test was carried out from a mobile launcher. Regarding this one, this missile was randomly chosen from the production stock and the entire launch activity was carried out by the Strategic Force Command of the Indian Army, and it was monitored by the scientists of the DRDO as a part of the training exercise as said by the defense sources. Downrange teams onboard a ship deployed near a designated impact point in the Bay of Bengal monitored the terminal events and splashed on. Prithvi 2 missile is capable of carrying 500 to 1000 kilograms of warheads and is powered by liquid propulsion twin engines as said by the sources. That's it regarding the most important defense updates for today. So now we will have a review of the questions of all the topics that we have discussed. So if you have to discuss all the important topics, all the topics we were discussed, the first thing that we discussed today was about the Indian Coast Guard Academy. And then later on, we were also discussing about the DRDO Abhyas, the heat target also we discussed. We also discussed about the passage exercise between Australian Navy and the Indian Navy. The fourth important update that we discussed for today was about the Naval Investiture Ceremony. This also we discussed about it and how the Southern Naval Commander has presented the gallantry and the non-gallantry awards to the Naval Meritorious Personnel. And in the fifth, we also discussed about the JIMEX bilateral naval exercise between Indian Navy and the Japanese Maritime Self-Defense Force Navy. We also discussed in the sixth point about the Defense Acquisition Procedure 2020 in a very detailed way about different types of the buyers, the vendors, the procurement details, the indigenous content and all. And then in the seventh important update, we discussed today about the Gunner's Day. Okay, Gunner's Day means what? It is the raising day of the core of the artillery, regiment of the artillery of the Indian Army. And then we also discussed in a very detailed way about the BrahMos missile, which was completely made regarding the indigenous material. And then in the 9th important update, we also discussed about the DRDO's anti-tank guided missile. And in the 10th update, we discussed regarding that the Lieutenant General Harinder Singh has become the new commandant of the Indian Military Academy. Okay, he was previously the 14 Corps commander, but he is now the commander of the Indian Military Academy. And then later we also discussed that Major General Sonali Ghoshal has been appointed as the additional Director General of the Military Nursing Service. This she was appointed very, very recently. And then later on we also discussed about the Air Force Day parade. Okay, that was conducted very recently, that means on 8th of October 2020, the 88th Air Force Day, which was conducted at the Air Force Station Hindon. If you go through the 13th important update, there we discussed about Exercise Bongo Sagar and the coordinatorial patrol exercise that was conducted between Indian Navy and the Bangladeshi Navy. And then we also discussed about the important establishment that was built for the Galwan Valley Martyrs. Okay, so even that we also discussed regarding that. And then later on we also discussed in very detail regarding the nuclear capable Shaurya missile. Okay, and then after Shaurya missile we also discussed in detail regarding that the Lieutenant General T.S.A. Narayanan becomes the 68th commander of the core of the EME, of the Electronics of Mechanical Engineers. He is also the commandant of the Military College of Electronics and Communications Engineering. So after that he now became the core commandant. And then we later on discussed about the smart missile. What is the full form of the smart? It is a torpedo. What is it? It is a supersonic missile assisted release torpedo. Okay, so this particular torpedo is released by a supersonic missile. It achieves the targets of the supersonic speed. And then we also discussed in detail regarding the raising day of the Territorial Army, the 71st raising day, which was conducted on 9th of October 2020. And then later on we discussed about the Rudram anti-radiation missile, which is developed by DRDO and which was flied off very recently from the Balasore test range. And then later on, we also in the final one, we discussed about a very recent update about the Prithvi 2 missile, which is yesterday at night 7:30, it blasted off, and very details regarding that were also there. So all the important questions that I'm going to discuss from now will include all of these topics or some of these topics. So these will be very, very important. And I hope that you people will also go through the important PDF study material and also the article that we publish regarding this particular one. Okay, so going through the first and foremost question, India's first Coast Guard Academy, it will be established at what place? It will be established at Mangaluru. Okay, the next question is, DRDO has conducted a successful flight test of Abhyas on 22nd September 2020 from Balasore, Odisha. Abhyas is a heat target. The full form of heat is, the full form of heat is high expended expendable target. Okay, it is high speed expendable aerial target. Coming to the next important question, the Indian Navy undertook a passage exercise with Australian Navy RAN in what? It undertook this particular exercise in Eastern Indian Ocean region. And when this particular happened? It happened on the 23rd to 24th of September 2020. Okay, this passage exercise was happened from 23rd to 24th of September 2020. Going through with the next important question, is the passage exercise between Indian Navy and Australian Navy involved the participation of which ship from the Australian side? It was HMAS Hobart, which practiced its drills with the Indian Navy. The next important question is, Indian naval ships Sahyadri and Karmukh have recently participated in an exercise with which country's navy? It is the Australian Navy. The next question is, Vice Admiral A.K. Chawla, PVSM, AVSM, NM, BSM, ADC is the Flag Officer Commanding in Chief of which Naval Command? He is the Flag Officer Commanding in Chief of the Southern Naval Command, who was involved in the conducting of the investiture ceremony at the Southern Naval Command in Kochi. Going through with the next important question is, the 4th edition of India-Japan Maritime Bilateral Exercise JIMEX, which is conducted biennially between both Indian Navy and Japanese Navy, it was held at what place? Recently it was held in the Northern Arabian Sea. Remember, it was held at the Northern Arabian Sea. Going through with the next important question is, the JIMEX was conducted from what dates to what date? It was conducted from 26th to 28th of September 2020. Remember, that it was conducted on 3 days. So it was conducted from 26th to 28th of September 2020. The next question is, in JIMEX 2020, Indian side was commanded by the flag officer commanding Western Fleet. Who he was? He was commanded by Rear Admiral Krishna Swaminathan. Okay. Also, you can mention in the comment section the interested candidates. Who is Vice Admiral Ajit Kumar P? Who is Vice Admiral Anil Kumar Chawla? Who is Rear Admiral Sanjay Jasjit Singh? The next important question is, which among these warships did not participate in JIMEX 2020? So, the JIMEX 2020, which among these did not participate? Only INS Chennai, INS Tarkash and INS Deepak have participated in JIMEX 2020. INS Harihant did not participate. Okay. So, what are these? The indigenously built stealth destroyer INS Chennai, T-class stealth frigate INS Tarkash and the fleet tanker INS Deepak were the only three ships from the Indian side that had participated in the JIMEX 2020. And from the Japanese side, it was JMSDF Kaga and JMSDF Ikazushi that has participated with this particular exercise. So the next important question is that only the Japanese Navy, JIMEX 2020 was led by which particular commander of the Japanese Navy? It was led by the Rear Admiral Kono Yoshisuke. Okay. The next important question is, the first defense procurement procedure was promulgated in which year? It was promulgated in the year of 2002. The next question is, DPP 2016 was released replacing the DPP 2013 based on the recommendations of which committee? It was based on the recommendation of the Dhirendra Singh committee. The next question is, Innovations for Defense Excellence, IDEX, has been operationalized to provide necessary incubation and infrastructure support to what kind of organizations or what in the defense area? It was provided only for the startups. Okay. So IDEX is to provide the necessary incubation and infrastructure support to the startups of the defense area. The next question is, which mission was launched to promote a greater culture of innovation and technology development and file a higher number of patents in DPSUs or Defense Public Sector Undertaking? So, what is the name of that particular mission which was launched to promote a greater culture of innovation and technology development and file a higher number of patents? So, it involves the protection of the intellectual property rights, and that particular mission is Mission Raksha Gyan Shakti. Okay. So, going through the next question is, Dash Regiment of Indian Army on 28th of September celebrates Gunner's Day every year. The Gunner's Day means it is the Regiment of Artillery. Okay. So, Regiment of Artillery celebrates its raising day on 28th of September and they call it as the Gunner's Day. The next question is, the BrahMos land attack cruise missile featuring indigenous booster airframe section along with many other made in India subsystems, it was cruising at a top speed of what? As per the information that we have already read and that explained from my side, it was cruising at a top speed of the Mach 2.8. Okay, remember it is Mach 2.8. The next question is, the indigenously developed laser guided anti-tank guided missile or ATGM, it was successfully test fired on 1st of October 2020, defeating a target located at longer range. Now, this test was conducted from which battle tank? This particular missile, it was launched from the main battle tank MBT Arjun. The next question is, Bongo Sagar exercise was followed by third edition of Indian Navy, Bangladeshi Navy Coordinated Patrol Corpat in Northern Bay of Bengal from what date to what date? It was conducted from 4th to 5th of October 2020. On 3rd of October, Bongo Sagar exercise was conducted in a very detailed way, but the coordinated patrol drills, the Corpat, these were conducted on 4th to 5th of October 2020. Okay, so these were the follow-up drills after the Bongo Sagar exercise. The next important question is, which among these ships have participated in recently conducted Bongo Sagar exercise? Is it INS Kilton or INS Kukri or both of them or neither of them? The correct answer is both of them. Okay. So both INS Kilton and INS Kukri, both of them have been indigenously developed by the Indian government. So both of these have participated in the Bongo Sagar exercise. From the Bangladeshi side, which particular ship has participated? It is the BNS Abu Bakr. Okay. It was BNS Abu Bakr that has been participated in the Bangladeshi Navy's Bongo Sagar exercise. The next question is, on 3rd of October 2020, India successfully test fired a new version of nuclear capable which missile off the coast of Odisha which can strike targets at around 800 kilometers. So the correct answer is, it is the Shaurya. It is the nuclear capable Shaurya missile. The next question is, Lieutenant General T.S.A. Narayanan, the Commandant of Military College of Electronics and Mechanical Engineers of Secunderabad, he has been elected as the 69th Colonel Commandant of what? He has been elected as the 69th Colonel Commandant of the Corps of EME. The next question is, when did Territorial Army celebrate its 71st Raising Day? Territorial Army celebrates its Raising Day on 9th of October every year. The next question is, a new generation anti-radiation missile was successfully flight tested on 9th of October 2020 onto a radiation target located on Wheeler Island. It is named as what? The anti-radiation missile that is developed by DRDO, the first such kind of missile for the Indian Air Force, then it was named as Rudram. Okay. So the next question is, Rudram missile was launched from which fighter aircraft? So Rudram was launched from the Indian Air Force Sukhoi Su-30 Mark 1 fighter aircraft. That is it regarding the most important questions. And the question of the day for today is this one. Kartavyam Anvatma is the motto of which regiment of Indian Army? See, I know that you people who are watching all the way up to here, the 1 hour defense updates until now, you have been already stressed out with a lot of information, and I am very, very happy that each and every one of you have reached at this particular level and you are listening to each and every important point, and I am very elated and I feel very, very happy for each and every one of you. And I hope that an easy question will be helpful for you in taking a break. So this particular question is for you. Okay. So just mention the regiment of that particular Indian Army which carries its motto as Kartavyam Anvatma. So the answer for this and the correct explanation for it and various other day-to-day daily defense current affairs will be given up by SSB Crack Exams from the coming up days. Until then, always stay tuned to SSB Crack Exams. Subscribe to this channel. Download our Android app from Google Play Store. Always stay safe, stay healthy, eat healthy food, keep smiling, be confident. Jai Hind.